see what it says. Santa at the mall.
All right.
We better get ready. Good morning, everybody. Hope you're doing great. Hope you're having an awesome day. It's Kate from Wild Tales Of. If you're new here on YouTube and on my blog, wildtalesof.com, I share about family travel and outdoor adventure. But this month is a little extra special because we are sharing lots of holiday adventures all around the Seattle area. So today, as you saw, we are going to see Santa now. Last weekend, we saw Santa at the dentist, but this weekend, we are headed up to one of our local malls where we are going to see Santa there. And this Santa is one that we've been visiting since Bergen was a toddler. And I shared this last year, and you can watch our video from last year. We actually headed down to Tacoma to see him. Here, I'll show you all the photos over the years really quick. Here's the very first one, and then Georgia came into the picture here, and he's been at various places over the years. That one, and then you can tell that one was 2020, obviously. So this year we are headed actually up north. He's north at the Alderwood Mall in Linwood, Washington. A little bit north here, so we're gonna hit the road and go, hopefully, not have to wait in too long of a line to see him, because there aren't any reservations when we checked, so we're just going to roll the dice and see if we can get there early enough to be able to talk to him and be able to visit with him. So come along on our adventure up to see Santa.
Woo-hoo! Look at those snazzy pants. Where did you get those? Tell us about your pants.
These pants are made for walking.
Did you just buy them at the store?
No.
Where did you get them?
These were willed to me from my grandpa.
Pretty cool.
Papa Choo Choo.
And he's also George's namesake.
He used to just wear these in the office, kicking his feet up on the desk.
That's right. Woo!
Had to get them all altered.
What is it? Over there?
That's where we're gonna get to sit.
And do what?
Take pictures.
Nice. Here he comes.
Down the...
I see him. Santa's right over there. He wanted us to do a silly one this year. That one. The kids were kind of stunned. Thank you. this. Look at this parking spot. We're going right there. The sign. Look at guys. There's a trolley. The Friday Harbor trolley.
Several days later from when we were having that adventure to go and see Santa up in Linwood, Washington. And then you saw it, we actually ventured over to Edmonds, Washington, which we have shown on the vlog before. So I'll link the video all about Edmonds, but we needed to run some errands there and we ended up stopping at the brewery for some lunch. Then we even saw that their outdoor market was going on. So we stopped in there and did a little shopping and got some coffee too. That afternoon ended up getting away from us and so we weren't able to finish out that video. So I wanted to continue on a little bit. And since we saw Santa, I thought it might be fun to share. Now these are gonna be last minute, but these gift ideas can maybe last the whole year through. So if you need some outdoor and travel inspired gifts for kids, I wanted to share a few of them here. You can use them as last minute gift ideas, or if you're watching this later on, maybe there's some birthdays or other celebrations coming up where you need a gift. So the kids and I actually came up with this list. We have a video from last year, last December, and I will link that here as well. So the idea is that these gifts either inspire them to get outside or actually get outside or kind of inspire some travel or help them learn more about the world in general. So without further ado, I'll just get started. And if I can find links, then I will link all the things below. And I want to give credit to our awesome family and friends, because it's mostly because of them that we have a lot of these things, because they are the ones who kind of think of the kids and think of their interests and, you know, some of our family values and things like that. And they think of these ideas and it's pretty cool. So I'll start with this one, and it's a little worse for the wear because it's been outside for a really long time, probably since last spring. But it's a little mini garden and it looks a lot cuter when you see it in the box. And so make sure to check out the link below. But Georgette received this little mini garden as a gift, either for Christmas or her birthday. It's always so hard because they're really close together. But it came with seeds for flowers. So I think it was like zinnias and marigolds and cosmos, I think. That doesn't really matter, but it's just a kit and she was able to, oh, here is a better look, paint the outside of it. So it came with paint to decorate, and then it has these little cute wooden mushrooms that she painted, and then it also came with these plant markers so she could mark where she planted the seeds, and then obviously everything else needed to plant a little flower garden. So we had that out in front of our house and it did really well. And it was just a fun project that we started inside and then were able to continue on and enjoy for a long time. Okay, next is this really cool remote control speedboat. So this one is obviously waterproof, goes in the water, and it's pretty easy to run. This is a gift that Bergen received. It's encouraging kids to get outside because you really have to get outside in order to use it. And he has used it at some ponds and even on Lake Washington, kind of in this little wetlands area. So the water's calm and there wasn't so much of a worry for the boat to get carried away or anything, but there is a little bit of that concern. So you have to be careful, but it's been a lot of fun for him to take this boat out and find different places to ride it around. And it's a great gift for kids who maybe lean towards the side of wanting to use technology a lot. And so because it is something that they can control and it uses technology, but it also gets them outside at the same time. Now this one, I feel like a lot of people have probably heard of this. It's a stomp rocket, and we've actually shown it on the vlog before. I'll link that up here. The kids have used it a lot. You can see here in the picture that has this pad, and the kids stomp on it and the rocket goes in different places, and you can like load it in different ways to get different types, to get the rocket to do different types of things. So that's a lot of fun for the kids to like mess around with how exactly to situate the stomp rocket and for it to go. And they'll just do this for a really long time. It's lots of fun. Okay, next up is this rock tumbler. It's from National Geographic. We have done a whole vlog on this rock tumbler, and I'll link that here. But you're not using the rock tumbler outside. It doesn't get the kids outside. But with it being associated with rocks, you can go look for rocks and then use your tumbler to then, you know, shine them up and polish them. And it just gets them thinking about outdoorsy things. So the rock tumbler comes with the tumbler itself, and then it also comes with some sets of rocks, and then you can buy, and then all the grit and things that you need in order to get them polished. And then you can also buy more kits of different types of rocks that you can then polish. I particularly think it's really neat to go looking for rocks, especially like go on a beach walk and collect different rocks, maybe collect some agate. It makes me think of the time where we went to the Oregon coast and then doing some tumbling from there. So that's kind of an idea. But Bergen absolutely loves this rock tumbler, and he's gone through several different cycles in the past year or so that he's had it. So definitely recommend the National Geographic Hobby Rock Tumbler. Another item that Bergen absolutely loves is this microscope. He and Slade did a bunch of research on Amazon, and they purchased this microscope. He really wanted to be able to put things under here and see them up close. He had just had this strong desire to collect things and then just really be able to examine them. I think a little bit of it stemmed from the rock tumbler, where he tumbled the rocks and then he really wanted to be able to look at them up close. And it also came with a bunch of different slides, so that was a lot of fun, like to get to look up at some of the things that were selected on those slides up close. And he's had a lot of fun. It's great for when friends come over and they can kind of just pour over all of those different slides. And he and Georgia also have a lot of fun looking at things under here. So it's just kind of a great thing just to have around the house. And I will say it's something that he forgets about, but then once he remembers, then it like sparks up a whole new long session of looking at things under the microscope. So it's kind of, it's just a great thing to have for kid, for especially kind of that elementary age, school age kids, just a great thing to have for when those times come when you, oh, I really want to examine this. And then you just have it, have that opportunity. So also makes a great gift, and I'll leave a link below to the one that we got on Amazon. Next up, along the same lines as a microscope, is a good pair of binoculars. This is one of the pairs that we have. We have several different ones. These are the ones that Slade actually passed down to the kids because he got a new pair. He uses them mostly at sporting events, but we encourage the kids to bring them along on hikes and different walks because they're great for bird watching and just checking out things far away. There's been so many times where we've been walking along and there's, you know, an eagle high up in a tree and we want to get a better look. And so I love it when we actually have brought our binoculars along. Oh, along the same lines, Bergen had mentioned once to my dad that he made a spyglass. This was really early on in the pandemic, and he had made a spyglass just out of like a toilet paper tube or maybe a paper towel roll. And my dad was like, oh, he's making a spyglass. So he just thought it would be fun, and he sent him an actual like telescope spyglass. We have since lost it, but that also makes a great gift, and it's kind of fun, just a different novelty kind of thing, just makes for a different experience when you have, you know, this one lens kind of thing that you're, you know, you can act like a pirate or kind of, or a spy kind of. Sparks a little bit more imagination than the binoculars do. So if I can find a link to that, I'll also put that below. And you can see the kids in action when we went to the Montlake neighborhood here in Seattle and we did a bunch of birding. So I'll leave a link here too. One more gift idea, and then Bergen grabbed a bunch of books that also kind of inspire him to get outside and also and travel. So the last one is this glow-in-the-dark Frisbee. So cool. It lights up different colors, as you can see. And it's super fun, especially at night, obviously. Now that we actually are getting very close to winter solstice. It's on Tuesday, tomorrow. And so we're finally gonna be gaining some light back, but still, especially in the winter months when it's dark here so soon, it feels like it's dark at like 3:30 in the afternoon. And so when we are headed out for our afternoon walks finally, it feels like it's already dark even before we actually start. So this is a really neat item to bring along on our walks. If we make it to a playground or a field or a park or something, then the kids can toss it around and that's a lot of fun. Next, I have a bunch of books that I'm just gonna share really quickly in case you wanted a few book ideas. There are also some more book ideas, some series in particular on our last video from last year. Okay, this one goes with the rock tumbler, so maybe if you wanna do a little combo, this is a rock and mineral nature guide. So Bergen, I think, actually bought this himself at a local bookstore. And so it just tells you all the names of the different rocks and minerals and information about them. It's a great guide. These go together. Bergen got these from his uncle and cousins and aunt. And they are, this is pretty cool. So it's how to camp in the woods, how to stay alive in the woods, and how to eat in the woods. Bergen just loves looking through these. They're really neat to bring along, especially like if we're going out to eat or he's kind of knows that he's gonna be in the car and sitting. It's just kind of fun to like pick up and read a little bit here and there. Fun like conversation starters. And the next one is, we actually found this in a little free library. And it's 100 countries, 5,000 ideas. Where to go, when to go, what to see, what to do. It's a National Geographic book. Beautiful color photographs. Just another great one to bring along when he knows he's kind of be sitting for a while. Great one to just look through and get inspired. And this is a book for adults too. I think it's actually really geared toward adults, but that really caught his eye when he saw that. I don't blame him. And then the last one, Bergen had wanted this book forever. I think he kept eyeing it like at the Amazon bookstore. Finally, I don't remember what the occasion was, but he got to pick this up and it's Hidden Wonders. It's Lonely Planet Kids, and it's a guide to the planet's wildest, weirdest places. So you can imagine why he was interested in that. It's a really cool cover too. And so it just, again, just like the National Geographic book, but it's got great photographs and just talks about really interesting different places all around the world. Also a fun book to bring along to when we're going out to dinner. Also fun to bring along on a trip. So that's Lonely Planet Kids Hidden Wonders. And that's it. Just wanted to share a quick few more gift ideas in case you need a last minute, because it would be very pretty last minute to get this to ship in time for Christmas. But maybe you have another holiday or another celebration or a birthday's coming up, and I just thought it would be fun to throw these ideas out since we just saw Santa. Who knows? Maybe you can find these two at your local stores, hopefully, because we are all about getting out and supporting those local small businesses. Hope those gave you some ideas if you're looking for some. Make sure to leave your ideas down in the comments below, because we would love to hear about other items, other toys, other gifts that inspire kids to think about travel, inspire kids to get outdoors, or just continue their imagination and their learning and further foster their creativity and knowledge. So thanks so much for joining us. We hope you are having an amazing day. Make sure to hit that like button if this was helpful to you and if you enjoyed. And we would love for you to subscribe. So make sure to subscribe and ring the bell notification so you can join us on all of our adventures. And we hope you're staying happy and healthy, and we hope you are getting out and having some brave, wild adventures, and we'll see you next time.